To make right decisions, use your renewed mind. Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. So the Bible teaches here and in other places this whole process of renewing the mind. As believers, we need to renew our mind, renew our way, our patterns of thinking and how we think. That's renewing our mind and renewing the attitude of our mind, renewing the perspective of perspectives of our mind. So what does that mean? What does it mean to renew our mind? It means that we lay aside our old pattern of thinking, or the way of thinking of this world, and we take on the ways and the thoughts of God. Like God tells us in Isaiah 55, he says, my ways are higher than your ways, my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. So in the process of renewing our mind, what we are essentially doing is learning to think in line with God's ways and God's thoughts. And as we begin to do that, our mind is being renewed. It is beginning to think aligned to God's ways and God's thoughts, instead of the ways and the thoughts of the wicked or of the world or of the fallen man. So when we renew our mind, what Romans 12 and verse 2 tells us is that by the renewing of our mind, we are able to prove, that is determined through a process of testing, we are able to prove what is good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. That means what is good in God's eyes, what is acceptable in his eyes, and what's perfect in his eyes. Now, you know, sometimes people say that there are three categories of God's will. Some is good, and some is acceptable, and some is perfect. And I don't think that's what the Apostle Paul is saying. He's just using three different adjectives to talk about the same thing, which is the will of God, what is in the will of God. So whatever is in the will of God is good, acceptable, and pleasing to him. And that's what we are trying to arrive at. We're not trying to arrive at three different kinds of the will of God. We're arriving at what is the will of God, which is obviously something good, acceptable, and perfect to him. But how do we arrive at that? Paul is telling us that when we renew our mind, we will be in a position to prove through a process of testing this will of God, what is really good, acceptable, and pleasing to God. So here's the thing I want to challenge you with. Renew your mind. That means you begin to fill your mind with the ways and the thoughts of God by reading his word and listening to his word and listening to his spirit. And then with that renewed mind, you put to test all the information that you get. You put to test what is around you. You put to test, you process information, you process things. And as you process things with your renewed mind, you will be able to arrive at what is the will of God, what is good, acceptable, and pleasing to him. Now, here's a mistake many believers make. They think that to know the will of God, you don't need to use your mind. Nothing can be further than the truth. God himself has given us our mind. God has given us our ability to think and reason, and it is God who has told us to renew our mind and to use that renewed mind to prove, to determine through a process of testing what is his will. So make sure that you use your renewed mind. It's like what the Apostle Paul says in Ephesians 5. He says, I want you to walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, understanding what the will of the Lord is. You've got to understand God's will. So use your renewed mind to determine God's will. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the mind you've given to us. We submit it to you. We pray you'll help us renew our mind and use our renewed mind to determine your will. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.